In this problem, we're given two blocks with mass 2 kilograms and 4 kilograms, tied together with a string on a smooth horizontal surface, and these blocks are pulled along by an applied force of 25 newtons, pulling horizontally to the right. The goal of the problem is to find the tension in the string that connects these two blocks, and we're actually going to explore a couple different ways of solving the problem and then checking our work. So we start with probably the most efficient way to solve the problem. And in this approach, we view the two masses as a single 6 kilogram mass. This is allowed because we know the acceleration of both masses must be the same. So this external force of 25 newtons is responsible for accelerating all 6 kilograms here. And this acceleration of the system is the unknown we're trying to find first. Well, we can quickly get this acceleration by applying Newton's second law in the x direction. So we can write Newton's second law as A equals F net over M. You may be used to seeing this as F net equals MA, but I solved for the acceleration there. And the net force on this collected 6 kilograms of mass is 25 newtons pulling to the right. The total mass that's being accelerated here is 6 kilograms. And when we run the numbers on this and round to our usual 3 significant digits, we end up with an acceleration of 4.17 meters per second squared. Now that we have the acceleration of the system, we can go back to either individual mass and apply Newton's second law again. And the analysis is going to be simplest on the 4 kilogram block here because the tension is the only force on this guy in the x direction. So we already know that the acceleration is 4.17 meters per second squared for this block. And now we apply Newton's second law to this individual 4 kilogram block. So we write F net equals MA for the analysis on the 4 kilogram block, and the net force is just the tension pulling to the right. That's the only horizontal force acting on this block. So we have T is equal to MA. The mass of the block is 4 kilograms. It's accelerating along at 4.17 meters per second squared, and we arrive at a tension of 16.7 newtons. Note there that a kilogram meter per second squared is a newton. So we've got the answer to the original question, but now I want to check my work. And one way to check our work is to just do the force analysis on the 2 kilogram block. So again, the acceleration of that block is known. We already figured out that's 4.17 meters per second squared. And now we're just going to solve for the tension again and make sure that it agrees with the first answer. So applying Newton's second law to the 2 kilogram block, again, we write F net equals MA. But this time, there's two forces acting in the x direction. We have 25 newtons pulling to the right, so 25 newtons, minus the tension acting to the left. So 25 minus T, that's our net force, and that's equal to M, this 2 kilogram mass, times our acceleration, 4.17 meters per second squared. So we need to isolate the tension here. And so the way I think about it is we add the tension to the right side and then we subtract the 2 times 4.17 over to the left side. Solving for T there, we get that T is 25 newtons minus this 2 kilograms times 4.17 meters per second squared. Now taking 25 minus 2 times 4.17, we arrive at the same tension, 16.7 newtons. All right, so we answered the question, we found the tension in the string, and we actually did this in two different ways, so we've checked our work, we have a high degree of confidence we're correct. But before we quit on this problem, I want to illustrate a more systematic approach. And this kind of thinking is going to be useful in the long run as our problems become more complex. So this more systematic approach is that we're going to look at all the forces on all the pieces of the system all at once. So we're showing that tension pulling on the 4 kilogram block, that's the only horizontal force it experiences. And then the tension pulling to the left on the 2 kilogram block, and then our external force pulling to the right at 25 newtons on that 2 kilogram block. And both of these blocks share the same unknown acceleration, A. And what we do is just apply Newton's second law to each of these individual masses, and this is going to build a system of equations. So I'll start with the 4 kilogram block. And the Newton's second law analysis of the 4 kilogram block, that would be F net equals MA. And the net force there is just T. So that's equal to 4 kilograms, that's the mass, times the unknown acceleration A. Now we do a similar thing for the 2 kilogram block. We write down F net equals MA. But this time the net force is going to be 25 newtons to the right minus T, because it points to the left. That's equal to MA, so 2 kilograms, multiplied by this unknown acceleration. Now this is actually a system of 2 equations and 2 unknowns. And at this point, I want to just ignore the units on everything to clean it up. So our system of equations is T equals 4A, and 25 minus T is equal to 2A. Our 2 unknowns there are the tension and acceleration. And this system of equations is already set up to use elimination. All I do here is add the 2 equations together. And when I do that, on the left-hand side, I have a T and a negative T. So those are eliminated. All that's left on the left-hand side is my 25. And on the right-hand side, 4A plus 2A is 6A. When I solve for A, I get 25 over 6, which is the same 4.17 meters per second squared that we originally found. Now we have a choice to plug this A back in to either one of the original equations in the system. Either way we go, we're going to end up with the same value for the tension. So I choose the simpler of the 2 equations, T equals 4A. So I have T equals 4A, but A is 4.17, and we arrive at the same tension of 16.7 newtons, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.